Welcome to this video on constructions. In the previous video, we solved some questions based on the construction of a triangle. We constructed triangles for which information about their base side, one base angle, and the difference of the measure of the other two sides was given. In this video, we will learn to construct a triangle for which information is given about the sum of its three sides, that is the perimeter and the measure of its two base angles. So let's understand this construction. First of all, let's see what information is necessary for this construction. 1. The sum of all three sides and 2. Measure of the two base angles on the base side are needed. Now let's learn to construct. For example, let's assume we have to construct a triangle PQR whose perimeter is PQ plus QR plus RP and the base angles are angle Q and angle R respectively. Steps for the construction of such a triangle are as follows. Step 1. First of all, with the help of a scale, we will draw a line segment equal to the given perimeter and we will name it as XY. Here, PQ plus QR plus RP is equal to XY. Step 2. Now, from the vertex X, with the help of a protractor, while making an angle equal to the angle Q, we will draw a ray XZ. Step 3. Similarly, from the vertex Y, with the help of a protractor, while making an angle equal to the angle R, we will draw another ray YW. Step 4. Now, with the help of a compass, we will draw the angle bisectors of angle X and angle Y. Step 5. Let's name the point at which the bisectors of angle X and angle Y intersect as P. Your P is a vertex of triangle PQR. Friends, can you tell why we chose only vertex P from triangle PQR? Because angle Q and angle R are base angles. Therefore, we will take the point of intersection as point P, which is not the base angle. Step 6. Now, with the help of a compass, we will draw the perpendicular bisector of the line segment XP. Which intersects the line segment XY. And we will name this point of intersection as vertex Q of triangle PQR. Step 7. Similarly, we will draw the perpendicular bisector of the line segment YP with the help of a compass. Which will intersect the line segment XY at point R. Step 8. We will join point P with point Q and point R. And thus we constructed triangle PQR when we had information about its perimeter and the base angles. To summarize the steps of this construction, we can say that by drawing the line segment equal to the measurement of the perimeter, we will draw the angle bisector of given angles and then construct a perpendicular bisector of the angle bisector. We will find one vertex of the triangle by intersection point of angle bisectors and we will get the remaining two vertices by the intersection of base and both the perpendicular bisectors. And this is how we get the triangle. But friends, as you know, we will have to prove that the given construction is correct. So, let's verify our construction. We have to prove two parts in this construction. In the first part, we will prove that XY is equal to PQ plus QR plus RP. And in the second part, we will prove that angle WYR is equal to angle PRQ. And angle ZXQ is equal to angle PQR. As we know from the construction that point Q is situated on the perpendicular bisector of XP, so PQ is equal to XQ. Similarly, the point R is situated on the perpendicular bisector of YP, so RY is equal to RP. As we can understand from the figure, the line segment XY is formed by combining the line segments XQ, QR and RY. That is, XY is equal to XQ plus QR plus RY. In this equation, substituting PQ in place of XQ and RP in place of RY, we will get XY is equal to PQ plus QR plus RP. Let's call it equation 1. Here, we have proved the first part. Let's move to the second part. You can pause the video and think how we will prove it. We have to prove that angle WYR is equal to angle PRQ. Friends, look at triangle PYR carefully. Side RP is equal to side RY because any point situated on the perpendicular bisector of a line segment is equidistant from the endpoints of that line segment. That is, triangle PYR is an isosceles triangle. Therefore, angle RYP is equal to angle RPY. Let's call it equation 2. Angle PRQ is equal to the sum of angles RYP and RPY according to the exterior angle property of a triangle. According to equation 2, we can write it like this as well. Here we got angle PRQ is equal to 2 times angle RYP and 2 times angle RYP is angle WYR. Because YP is the bisector of angle WYR. Similarly, we can prove that angle ZXQ is equal to angle PQR. So friends, we have verified the construction of this triangle, or we can say that the construction has been proved right. Thus, in the next session, we will solve some questions based on this construction and will construct the triangle according to the given measurement. In this session, we learned to construct a triangle given its perimeter and its two base angles. Meet you in the next session. Thank you.